हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर वर्ल्ड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद माय नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन सी प्रोग्रामिंग एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वेरिएबल इन सी लैंग्वेज। इट इज़ अ नेम ऑफ मेमोरी लोकेशन वेयर वी स्टोर डेटा। सो एक्चुअली वी यूज़ अ वेरिएबल टू असाइन द नेम टू अवर डेटा दैट वी यूज़ इन अवर प्रोग्राम। ओके, so you know that every input we give in the program, it goes to some memory, and we have discussed the data types in the previous video that there are many different types of data types like int, char, okay, float. So variable, let me give you an example. Sorry, suppose this is my memory, okay, and I want to store an integer value, let's say 10. Now you know that int data type has 2 bytes of memory. So in the whole memory, I will create a block of 2 bytes, okay, and give it a name, let's say A. Okay, so A is a name of the block having memory 2 bytes. So that means it can store int value inside it. Okay, so when I will write this int A is equal to 10, that means that this block, particular block of name A of size 2 byte, can store value 10 inside it because I have assigned 10 with A. I can use any other integer, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 100, 200, 300, any integer, okay. So that particular integer, when I will write like this, will go into that block. Similarly, if I create another block, okay, of the memory that is used by the character data type, then I will be able to store characters in that block. Let me give you an example. Suppose I have created a block and gave it name B, and this block has memory of the character data type. Okay, then when I will write like this, char B is equal to math, this means that this particular variable has kept this string inside it because it is able to store characters inside it because it has the memory of character type. But if here I will write any string like math here, it will not store because it has the memory of int data type. Okay, so these are the variables. So when we write like this, then our program automatically create a memory of the data type that is involved to store that particular value which is in front of that data type. Okay, then if I will print A or print B, then it will give us these outputs. If I print A, I will get 10 because computer then will take the information which is stored in that block out and show to us. Okay, first computer will create a memory for this input, then when we print output command, then computer will give us the output. Okay, it's very easy. Like when we go to library, books are arranged in specific shelves. In physics shelf we find physics book, in chemistry shelf we find chemistry book, in math section we will find math book. Okay, first we have arranged them there, and when we want a particular book, let's say I want a math book, in math section also there are specific different departments, like some belong to calculus, some belong to trigonometry. Okay, so we can use a catalog which are there. So when we want a particular book, we will find out it in the catalog, we will go to a specific location and we will take that out. Similarly, things happening here. Okay, now the variable are of three types, sorry, global variable, local variable and static variable, that we will discuss in the next video.